fan video just for you guys. Wanted to do a response to Bonnet Mom asking if she's paranoid. I mean, she apologized for the way she ended her last video, which I didn't really take it that way. But anyway, I would, given the stuff you were saying, I would personally, I would encourage you to continue making videos for a couple reasons. Number one, and I've said this to you before, I think that you are, you add to the group for sure. I know it's a bunch of guys for the most part, you know, spouting off about guy stuff, or maybe just not necessarily guy stuff, but guys takes on things or whatever. And then, I think a lot of people really respect you. Like, you're not coming in here and passing judgment on people. You're not like the typical, woman in that way. But from what you say, if you really live in a bubble out there, going off of what you said, you know, you live in this kind of crazy liberal bubble, then I think and we are sort of your connection to the outside world, then why would you sacrifice that? Why would you get rid of that? You know, why would you further, isolate yourself in that bubble? You know, I mean, you said it yourself that this is a good outlet for you. So I would encourage you to continue in that, if it's therapeutic for you and everything. You mentioned that group that said that they were supporters of the, not only did they say they were supporters of LGBTQ AI, which I don't know what like AI, IA, whatever, I have to figure out what that is, but not only did they say they were supporters of that, which you didn't have a problem with, but they said, if you don't support them, then you can fuck off and you're a piece of shit and blah, blah. And that's sort of where you drew the line. And I think you're exactly right. I think that is where it crosses the line and becomes bullying. Imagine you coming on YouTube and saying, I love Jesus, and if you don't, fuck you. It's a lack of respect for people who, it's a lack of tolerance for people who have different opinions. The hypocrisy is just staggering with people like that, where they get mad at Christians for saying, like, we're in our little holy huddle and we're going to exclude everybody outside of us, and they do the exact same thing, that they're in their little tolerance huddle. They're in their little, whatever, this huddle, that huddle, and anybody who can't get on board with it, needs to be murdered or, scoffed at or whatever, you know. I mean, they'll boycott your business in a heartbeat. You know, I mean, there's boycotts going on both sides, right? There's Christians boycotting Bud Light right now, and there's people trying to boycott you know, bakeries that won't make wedding cakes for gay couples. You know, I mean, you can call it a war. I mean, you know, you can call it a war, and that's been going on obviously for a long time, but you know, but no, I don't think that you were wrong to draw the line when it came to bullying, because bullying is not something that we are called to do. You're not called to be a bully, and therefore you should not tolerate being bullied. So that's that. And then, are you paranoid when it comes to AI? Probably not. That's a reason why you guys are looking at my ceiling fan. You're not looking at me anymore. Because I'm paranoid when it comes to that. And somebody quoted one of my favorite quotes, in the comment of your video. I can't remember who it was, but just because you're paranoid doesn't mean they're not after you. It's a great quote. I don't know who coined that initially, but very true. I was talking to somebody about this. I can't remember who. I made a video about this or something, like, where, you know, there's levels of paranoia, and there's levels of our obsession with paranoia, And there's certain levels of what will you do out of paranoia and what will you not do. So, you know, if you used to watch Alex Jones, I mean, he would get you thinking all kinds of crazy shit about, you know, he used to say that if you owned a certain type of appliance, whether it was GE or Whirlpool or whatever it was, that there were bugs in your refrigerator that were listening to your conversations and like reporting stuff back to the NSA or something like that. Let's just say that's true, okay? Let's totally concede that point, even though I really don't believe that, but let's say that it is true. What am I gonna do about that? What am I gonna do? Like, fuck it. I'm just gonna say what I'm gonna say, and if the NSA wants to listen to me talk through my refrigerator or through my microwave or whatever they're doing, then I guess they're gonna hear some of Shafe's strongest beliefs. They're probably gonna hear me bitching out my kids. They're probably gonna hear me, you know, doing all kinds of things that I shouldn't be doing, saying all kinds of things that I shouldn't be saying. You know, they're gonna realize what a horrible person I am. But when I look at the sheer amount of data that represents, I mean, imagine every single person in their entire, imagine every single person in America. How many people do we have in this country, including illegal aliens? Probably 400 million now. And, you know, we all own refrigerators. I mean, most of us own refrigerators. Think of all the conversations that, if that's true, again, I'm not saying it's true, but just think the whole thing through. Imagine how many conversations are being recorded then. Like, how are they going to be able to sift through all that information and do something about it? You know, you hear about, like, the FBI, they have a rap sheet, or they've interviewed this person and this person and this person, and they just said, he's not a threat, and they just let him go. And then a couple years later, that same person goes into a gay bar and kills a bunch of people. And then it makes the news, like, hey, you guys had, the FBI had him in custody 2 years before. Why didn't you keep him? And they're like, because we didn't have enough information. We didn't know he was going to do this. We didn't know he's going to do all this. You know, the FBI, they can't keep everybody in custody just because they have, because they're worried about them. You know how many people would be in custody right now if everybody who they were worried about could possibly go on a rampage? Like, there'd be millions more people in prison right now than there currently are. So, you know, the real question is, you know, if AI is really capturing all that information, it's really, like, what can they really do with all that info? Now, the real thing that I think to be concerned about is getting in their crosshairs. You don't want to get in the NSA's crosshairs. You don't want to get in the FBI's crosshairs. You don't want to get in the CIA's crosshairs. You don't want to get in anybody's crosshairs. Because then they can open up your file and they can look at all the data that they've been collecting on you, which they are collecting data, but by the way, I totally believe they're collecting data through Facebook, through YouTube, through your emails, through your phone searches, through everything. I mean, screw the whole idea of there's bugs in your refrigerator listening to you. I don't care if that's true or not. They don't need a bug in my refrigerator. All they gotta do is hit up Verizon and say, what's been Shafe's internet search activity for the past 3 years? And that'll tell them everything they need to know about me. Everything. I mean, everything I've ever ordered on Amazon, every email I've ever sent, every text I've ever sent, every email I've ever received, every text I've ever received, all the pictures that I've taken of myself and of my kids and of my wife and of my friends. And I mean, they would know more about me than I know about myself by looking at that stuff. And I'm sure that all this information is being captured, but I don't think they're going to do anything about it unless I get in their crosshairs. So in other words, if I decide to run for governor, if I decided to run for president, if I decided to run for this or that or whatever, now all of a sudden, now people start digging into the Shafe files. Ooh, this is interesting. Look at this. Look at this email. Look at that. That's interesting. We can use this against them. It's a matter of being a high profile person and getting in their crosshairs. That's the dangerous part of it, in my opinion. So that's my take. All right, see ya.